This class we discuss about Gauss Seidel method. Three equations are given. 3 is equal to 10x minus 5y minus 2z. Equation 1. Minus 3 is equal to 4x minus 10y plus 3z. Equation 2. Minus 3 is equal to x plus 6y plus 10z. Equation 3. Find the value of x, y, z. That is the question. First step, x is equal to 1 by 10. 3 plus 5y plus 2z. Y is equal to 1 by 10. 3 plus 4x plus 3z. Z is equal to 1 by 10. Minus 3 minus x minus 6y. If I calculate x, I know y and z. I can calculate x. And I know x and z, I can calculate y. And I know x and y, I can calculate z. For the first iteration, I choose y is equal to 0, z is equal to 0. I substitute in the x. I calculate x is equal to 0.3. I know x and z. X is equal to 0.3. Z is equal to 0. I can calculate y. Y is equal to 0.42. I know x is equal to 0.3. Y is equal to 0.42. Z is equal to minus 0.582. For the first iteration, x is equal to 0.3, y is equal to 0.42, z is equal to minus 0.582. The second iteration, I choose y is equal to 0.42, z is equal to minus 0.582. The same way I calculate x, y, z, it's the second iteration. I got x is equal to 0.3936, y is equal to 0.2828. Z is equal to minus 0.5090. In the third iteration, I choose y is equal to 0.2828. Z is equal to minus 0.5090. Again, I substitute x, y, z equations. X is equal to 0.3396. Y is equal to 0.3831. Z is equal to 0.5038. In the fourth iteration, I choose y is equal to 0.2831, z is equal to minus 0.5038. The fourth iteration value is x is equal to 0.3408, y is equal to 0.2852, z is equal to minus 0.5052. The fifth iteration, I choose y is equal to 0.2852, z is equal to minus 0.5052. The fifth iteration, x is equal to 0.3416, y is equal to 0.2851. Z is equal to minus 0.5052. Again, I will do the 6th iteration and 7th iteration. In the 7th iteration, the value just converts. X is equal to 0.342. Y is equal to 0.285. Z is equal to minus 0.505. Advantages are, number 1, it is very simple method. Number 2, useful for small systems. Number 3, the memory requirement is small. Number 4, calculations are very simple and requires less programming tasks to perform. Disadvantages are, number 1, not suitable for large systems. Number 2, requires large number of iterations to converge. Number 3, convergence time increases in the size of the system. These are all the advantages and disadvantages of Gauss Seidel method. Now we will work out one problem on Gauss Seidel method. The given problem is a 2 bus system. This is bus number 1, this is bus number 2. One is considered as a slack bus. SG1 is given 1 plus J1. SG2 is equal to 0 plus J1. Complex power demand SD1 is equal to 0.5 plus J1. Complex power demand ST2 is equal to 0.5 plus J1. Line impedance is given J0.4. The question is, calculate V2 using Gauss Seidel method. Line admittance is 1 by Z. 1 by J0.4 is equal to minus J2.5. I can form a Y bus. Minus J2.5 plus J2.5 plus J2.5 minus J2.5. S1 is equal to complex power generation minus complex power demand. SG1 minus ST1. S1 is equal to 1 plus J1 minus SD1 0.5 plus J1. S1 is equal to 0.5 per unit. S2 is equal to SG2 minus SD2. So SG2 is equal to 0 plus J1 minus 0.5 plus J1. Therefore S2 is equal to minus 0.5 per unit. S2 is equal to P2 minus JQ2. Slack bus voltage is 1 angle 0. We have to calculate V2. The formula is Vk is equal to 1 by YKK into PK minus JQK divided by Vk conjugate minus sigma k is equal to 1 to n, n is not equal to k, YKN into Vn. Here k is equal to 2. Therefore V2 is equal to 1 by Y22 P2 minus JQ2 divided by V2 conjugate minus Y21 into V1. Y22 is equal to minus J2.5, Y21 is equal to J2.5, P2 minus JQ2 is equal to minus 0.5, V2 conjugate is equal to 1 angle 0, V1 is equal to 1 angle 0. For the first iteration, V2 is equal to 1 minus J.2 per unit. The second iteration, V2 conjugate is equal to 1 plus J.2. So here V2 will become 0.962 minus J.192. The third iteration, V2 conjugate is equal to 0.962 plus J.192. The value is 1.04 minus J.2. The fourth iteration, V2 conjugate is 1.04 plus J.2. The value is 0.964 minus J.186. The fifth iteration, V2 conjugate is 0.964 plus J.186. The value is 0.962 minus J.2. So the value of V2 is 0.962 minus J.2. Almost the convergence takes place in the fifth or sixth iteration. For calculating I1 or I2, we need V1 and V2. This way we have to calculate V2 using Gauss-Seidel method. Thanks for listening.